Electronic Arts.
Hello, I am Test Drive, and welcome to my newest Let's Play. This is Need for Speed 4, or High Stakes. And I figured, since I mentioned something about it in one of the Carbon videos I'd done recently, that I had this game for the PC, and a lot of people were like, oh yeah, do that. So I'm like, okay. So, we're gonna play it. Basically, I've never played this game before. Well, I have a little bit. Like, not really the career or anything like that. It's just been... I did actually play online once, which was slightly strange. But, yeah, I've not... This game's gonna be basically a new experience for me. And, I already have pretty much all the options set up. So, let's get started with the career. Do that. Create. Creating player. So, we have to purchase our initial car. I have $25,000. And I have cars I can pick from. Ooh, BMW M5. Oh, it's an E39. Didn't think that the E39 was out by the time this game came out. So I'm assuming that the there's a car in light blue. There's a couple cars in light blue. I'm assuming those are the ones that I can actually afford. So it looks like we have either the BMW Z3 or the Mercedes SLK 230, which I will show off real quick. I think I'm going to go with the Z3, to be completely honest. I mean, the Mercedes is cool, but I think I'm going to go with the Z3. I am using a keyboard for this as well, so you'll hear me spamming the keyboard a lot. And you can change the color. You can make a custom color. Ooh! Will it update? No, I have to hit preview probably. Let's see, let's put this. Let's make it like kind of sky bluish. Ooh, I like that. Alrighty. Let's go with that. Showcase. You can see the stats. The car interior, you can see, which is pretty cool. This game does have an interior view, believe it or not. Slideshow, I'm assuming it just...
When the designers of BMW first penned the Z3 Roadster, they were determined to capture the essence of open-air sports cars of years gone by while incorporating every current technical refinement. The Z3 2.8 puts out over 190 horsepower and provides substantial torque in every gear, just what BMW enthusiasts expect.
Also, before getting anything, I have to give a big shout out to my friend Thunder over at the HG Central channel. He has basically hooked me up with this game and got it, you know, perfectly working, all the files right and everything. So go check out his stuff. He makes awesome videos, and I also may have something on there on his channel. So go check that out. Oh, I stopped it accidentally. Anyways, yeah, we're going to get this car. I didn't realize you could, like, have a thing that would be like, hey. So I think I go back, right? Yeah. And then I can compare versus other cars, which is pretty cool. Actually, you know what? I want to do that with the SLK real quick. And let's go ahead and go down. This game has a bunch of interesting cars to it. So, the BMW has a worse overall rating than the Mercedes, but it's got a lot better acceleration and braking. I don't think I really care. I'm pretty sure there's upgrades in this game as well, so it's no problem. So, let's go ahead and purchase. Also, you can test drive too. It says enter circuit down there. Let's go ahead and purchase our car. Okay. Wait. What did I do? I did something. Oh, there we go. Okay. So, my account has $5,000. Car expenses. You can get upgrades, as I said. Total spend on repairs, huh? Garage. You can see the car that I have. You can repair it. Upgrade it. How much does it cost to upgrade? Upgrade to... Nothing is available. I could upgrade to level 1. Actually, I can't because I don't have enough money. It's 6,000. I have 5,000. You can select which car you want. You can do the showcase again. You can change the transmission, which I'm going to keep this on automatic because I don't know the controls for stick shift. So, yeah. Convertible top up or top down. That's actually kind of cool. I'm going to keep it down. And we can sell it for 10 grand, of course, because it's half of what, you know, it costs new. And trophy room, I'm assuming, yeah, shows your trophies. You have a bunch of these different things. You have cheat codes shown down there. Showroom is new cars you can buy. And so it looks like we have the European tour to do. So I'm going to click on this. Circuit number 1, European Tour, tournament, skill level amateur, opponents 5, 2 laps, and stuff. You can even do that stuff here. Track. I can change the track? No. I can view track records. It just shows you the track settings, and then everything's the same over there. So, I believe we click enter circuit. No entry. You have an entry fee for someone, apparently. Huh, interesting. There's a layout for the track, as you can tell. And... 3, 2, 1, go! Do a little burnout. Yeah, my keyboard's gonna click, by the way. Like, that's my keyboard. Because I was too lazy to actually set up a controller. I might do that for a future episode, but for now, I'm just gonna leave it as is. And yeah, this game is also running at 1440p. Oh god, right now. Oh my god. Because I am a quality whore. Oh my god. Ah, stop touching me. Now is there? Okay, it does have damage like ratings or damage indicators on the top right. The lap time in the top left with the map. And the other cars, yeah, the other cars. Along with how far behind, how far ahead or, oh god, or behind they are from compared to you. And we are in first place. I'm pretty sure there's mods you can get to make this game look a lot better as well, but I'm pretty much content with it just being in a high-definition resolution. That's good enough for me. And I've heard that the PS1 version of this game is quite a bit different from the PC version. I'm not really sure of how exactly, but I'm pretty sure it is, just in general. But, yeah. I'm not going to worry about it. I'm winning by a lot. I'm winning by 4 seconds ahead of McGee, and then... I like the third name down, or fourth one down, including mine, Jam, and it's like meme spaced out and capitalized. I'm pretty sure it's probably like initials, like, you know, J-A-M, but it's kind of funny to look at and think of it as a meme spelling kind of thing. And still pretty far ahead. 3.6 seconds ahead of sixth place? First? Second place. Fat Cat. Hair? Okay, there's a lot of interesting names. McGee, Bogey, Jam, J-A-M, whatever. Hair and Fat Cat. I don't... Alright. What'd that say? Something about a lap? Or maybe final lap? Hey, this game doesn't look half bad for being from, you know, 2000. Oh my god, or 2001 was this game. I can't remember. My car is slightly sad on the left side now. Because I had to wreck it. I'm gonna have to repair my damage now. Come on, make it up the hill. They're catching up. Bogey is catching up a little bit. Although I'll probably lose him in the same spot I lost him in the last lap. Which I think was like this part here, honestly. Yeah, I definitely need to get a controller working because this is annoying. I have a controller plugged in. I just don't know if it actually accept it right away or not. Oh my god. Oh no. Make the turn. I didn't make the turn. There's a tree there. Go! I'm stuck. Reset. How do I reset? Horn, siren, reset. We're gonna make that R. There we go. God damn it. I'm pretty far behind now. I think I can make it ahead. I had some minor problems. I don't know. That first place is nearly 6 seconds ahead. I might be able to catch them now. Because I'm already catching these dinguses. Oh yeah, I think I got this. Oh my god, get out of the way. Get out of the way. I said get out of the way. Ah! Get the fuck out of the way, stupid Mercedes. Oh no. Oh no, there's a tree there. God damn it. Now, I don't know what's gonna happen if I lose this race, honestly. Oh my god, this sucks. I did amazing on the first lap, and then the second lap I just shit the bed completely. Take a little shortcut across the grass there. Take another little shortcut across. Oh my god. It's probably not a good thing to like reset each time, but I mean, I have nothing better to do. I'm gonna get in last anyway, so it doesn't really matter. And everybody's waiting on me. Whoops. I goofed a little bit. You placed last. Thanks, announcer man, for letting me know. So, yeah. I got 8 points. First place got 30. Alrighty, I guess we'll continue our repair car. I'll repair the engine real quick. And that'll be good enough. Alrighty. Let's continue. And I'll hopefully get in first this time. I don't want to get in, you know, last again. At least I got some points for being in last. Go! Like, that does a burnout, like, when it shifts in between first and second, and also second and third. That's a little more than a second gear scratch. Why are they, like, doing that? They're moving side to side in a strange... Oh, you fucker. Moving side to side... Oh, God. Oh, my God. You idiots. Go! Get out of the way! No, I will not let you back in front of me. You were the one that caused this, I think. Actually, I think the other guy was the one that caused it. They got spun around. And then the yellow car just kind of was there to watch, I guess. I don't know why I have my left hand on the keyboard at all. Actually, I think I had it on the reset button. Oh my god, I actually made that turn. I wasn't expecting that. Yeah, the physics in this game are going to take a little bit to get used to. Just because it's an old game. Which, you know, works a lot differently from a newer game. Such as, you know, like Carbon or whatever that I've been playing recently. I like how the speedometer also goes up to 250, and this car probably will never hit 250. Oh my god! I gotta learn that you're not going to spin out if you keep sliding while, or turning while sliding. What the hell just happened there? Oh, there goes that sign. A couple of red red. Wow, I am colorblind as well as stupid. Freaking yellow Mercedes SLs. Oh my god. Oh, get out of the way, you ding-dong. Please, let me pass you. I just want to pass you. There we go. Okay, I'm passed. Okay. That'll work on you guys, which I think I just already passed. Oh, God! Mercedes wasn't having any of that. Come on! Go! I guess I'll go to the left. I'm not sure if it actually makes a difference or not, except for the fact that I might wreck into something over here. That's not a a wall that would slide along. Man, I already am doing fantastic at talking.
It's the final lap.
It's the final lap. Ah. So a little bit more backstory. The oldest Need for Speed game I've played before this was Need for Speed 3 Hot Pursuit, which is still older than this, of course. Oh my god. Physics are being strange. But yeah, I've played Need for Speed 3 Hot Pursuit. Not Need for Speed Hot Pursuit 3, aka 2010. And I don't remember much of it, because it was years and years ago on my cousin's PlayStation 1. So it's kind of nice to like revisit the older PlayStation era of Need for Speed games. Because like I never really gotten into it before. So this will be kind of like the introduction for me into, you know, classic Need for Speed games. Which I'm kind of happy to do. Oh my god. Yeah, the oldest Need for Speed game I really owned before... Well, I technically own this, I guess. The oldest Need for Speed game that I've owned and actually, you know, played is Underground 1. And that's only played because I did a Let's Play on it a while ago. I have Hot Pursuit 2 for Xbox, but I've not really played it at all. Played it for a few minutes one day, and that was it. I'm ahead of everybody else. By a little bit, at least. But yeah, continuing on with the backstory. It was funny because I played PlayStation 1 games a lot back when I was a kid. Like Gran Turismo 2, like I said, Need for Speed 3. Sledstorm, which I actually currently have again, because that game was fantastic. But, like, I never really had a PlayStation until, like, 2010, I think? 2009, maybe? Which was when I bought my PlayStation that I currently have still. So...
Congratulations! Ooh. You placed first!
Best lap! So, I never really got into gaming until I got the original Xbox. I had some PC games, but they were kind of crappy. I had like Trackmania, Sunrise, and a deer hunting game. Also, I am very far from being in first place. Oh well. I can continue. And we'll see if I can win this race and see if I can do something with this, you know, race. But yeah, I was always like an Xbox person. From when I first started, you know, playing games. So this is pretty new to me. Alright. Let's go. I'm starting at first, which is fantastic, by the way. I'd much rather start in first than, you know, in last. Oh my god. Make the turn. Okay, made it. Maybe if I can get the controller working, I'll also use stick shift transmission. Because I just don't feel like, you know, using a keyboard for driving and also manual transmission. I'd rather not. Yeah, maybe I'll play, you know, Need for Speed 3, Need for Speed 2, and even Need for Speed 1. I plan on playing Porsche Unleashed at some point. But all the other earlier ones, not including this one, all the PS1 era games, I kind of want to play, just to, you know, get an idea of what they were like, at least. Even if they're not the most fantastic games out there. Still kind of cool to look back and see where the game series came from. Like, you've went from this to, you know, Need for Speed 2015. Which I would already say this is better than Need for Speed 2015, just because the game doesn't try to play itself for me. I have full control of the car. Oh, except for, you know, transmission, but that can be fixed. And there's an option for it in the game. So, it doesn't matter. I'm 9 seconds ahead of second place. Hello. Make the turn. Make this turn. And I also like to play some old just PS1 games in general, like PS1 racing games. Oh god. Again, I already plan on doing Gran Turismo and Gran Turismo 2 series sometime. I don't know when. I know the Test Drive series, the old Test Drive games, like Test Drive 5, 4, and 6, I think, are on PS1. I think that's the only ones that are on PS1. I can't remember. But anyways, I plan to, you know, dabble with some of that every now and then. Just because it's interesting. Something different from, you know, new games, or even, like, you know, somewhat new games. High-definition era of games, even though I'm playing this one in high-definition. And I have means to play other PS1 games in high-definition. My right rear wheel is kind of sad, I just realized. Ow. It's a little sad. Also, I'm now 11 seconds ahead of second place. I'll take it. I'm just hoping that this will actually, you know, bring me up to first place. That'd be nice. I doubt it will. Actually, I think it's impossible for me to get first place. To be completely honest. Just because I fucked up the first race. Which is always fantastic. Like, you know, determining your fate by losing one race. You know, I lost pretty hard, but still. Like, I don't know. Maybe it's the way the tournaments work. Just a thing that you gotta expect with tournaments. I see they're taking some cheeky shortcuts as well. Maybe I'll start taking cheeky shortcuts. Because obviously driving off-road doesn't really hurt you much at all. Ah! I overcorrected too much. Somehow I'm also, doing decently, well, besides the first race, with the keyboard. I didn't expect to do, you know, well at all with the keyboard. And, well, I would say keyboard and mouse, but there's no actual mouse usage in this game. Unless you want to, I guess, put buttons on it that you want to play. Nope, I lost. Oh, well.
Congratulations! You have successfully completed this circuit. You have been awarded the bronze medal.
Cool, I got in third. Oh.
Move on to the next circuit.
I don't know what I did. Anyways, I think I'll probably redo that race in between episodes just to, you know, get it gold, because I want to get gold throughout the entire game. And I guess next episode we will go on to the circuit number two. Actually, I'll do one thing before I leave. Go and repair the car. Repair all damage would cost $1,290. I don't care. If I can win again, or if I can retry that and win, I can have, you know, an extra $5,000, so I think it'd be worth it. But, oh, I don't want to do that. Not yet. Anyways, thank you all for watching this first episode of Need for Speed High Stakes. If you enjoyed, be sure to let me know in the comment section below, or with a like, or whatever. I would appreciate it. So thank you all for watching, and I'm out of here. See ya.